up, y'all?
Come get this commentary.
The best on these streets. I'm about to start the club up. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Kiva. I'm on a little break. I'm on my lunch break. And I'm like, let me do some commentary. Back in January, there was a couple. The husband had got some paperwork that stated that he had fathered a child, okay? And long story short, they were about to garnish his check and everything, and he took it to the news, right? So here in Michigan, if you give a name, a birthday, you can even show them social media information, anything to get your benefits. Because in Michigan, if you want food stamps and Medicaid and you have a child, you have to tell who the father is. Some women will lie. They will pull a name out the sky. It's Ricky Bobby. He live at 123 Avenue, and they will give him a Google number, okay? It happens all the time. But there are some women who will know somebody, or don't even know them, but know their name and their information because they happen to be Facebook friends with them. You just never know, and will turn that information over, okay? And boom, now this person is caught up on child support. Let's get to the story first, because so you can have context of what this family went through and how it affected the wife going through it, and how when you lie like this on men, you can damage so much more than just his pocketbook, okay? The marriage, the trust. The wife has every right to feel some kind of way. It's a woman stating this is your child. They're going to garnish your check, which is our income, right? So it comes down to a lot more than just you lying. You're damaging things. So let's get to their story, and then we'll catch up, because they got a result on that DNA
Derek,
test.
Thank you. It's a situation that will make you think of the song Billie Jean by the late Michael Jackson. A Metro Detroit man presenting some very strong accusations against friend of the court who is alleging he may be the father of a child. But the problem is, this happily married man tells me he's never met the mother. And now he's calling this entire ordeal a big mix-up, one that could have ruined his entire family.
Our name is worth more than anything.
To have a letter sent like this, it kind of assassinates your character and it brings your character into question.
My first emotion was like, what do you mean?
On a typical day in late December, D'Angelo Smith receives a phone call from his wife telling him the two of them need to talk after checking the mailbox.
Typically, I don't open up my husband's mail, but this particular piece of mail said friend of the court. So I'm like, I'm getting ready to open it up, you know, like, you know, what's going on?
The letter stated a woman who we are not naming is alleging that D'Angelo Smith is the father of her daughter, who is between the age of 1 and 2 years old.
Says she's a stripper from Detroit. We had a one night stand at some hotel that we supposed to have been and went to. And this is a story that was told to me.
The problem is, D'Angelo Smith tells me he has no knowledge of who this woman is.
Apparently they conducted two to three other interviews, and between those interviews, I don't know which one, she came back and said his name is D'Angelo Smith.
This husband and wife say they drove to Benton Harbor, more than 3 hours away from their home in Metro Detroit, following this court order for D'Angelo Smith to come in for genetic testing.
When you get a letter like this sent to your house, and having a wife and three children that live in a house with you, you know, my main goal is my wife's security and who I am.
If, you know, our relationship or our marriage were, you know, on the rocks, you know, or we had, you know, issues in the past that we patched up and this letter came, this letter alone is damaging to so many families.
Let's pause right there. She spoke volumes. There are families who have survived infidelities, and there are families who have survived infidelities with a child involved. Okay, so not only did the person cheat, but they got pregnant or they made a baby, and they still ended up working through and getting together, promising to never have this happen again. Imagine keeping that promise during good, and then boom, here comes this.
The wild turn in this roller coaster ride, the alleged mother never showed up for the court hearing.
I said, if this woman never shows up, I said, what is my recourse? What are my options? What am I able to do? And what complaints can I file for character assassination, you know, false accusations? She said, well, there's no way we can establish paternity unless she brings the baby in, which clearly we know that, right? I said, okay, but if she never brings the baby in, what are my options? You know, what complaints can I file? And she told me, as far as I know, there are no complaints you can file.
That means D'Angelo could end up being connected to this case until the child turns 18.
The concept is good. If you have a kid, why should the taxpayers pay for your kid if you're the father? The problem is proving it. And a lot of times the procedure is more difficult than the facts.
We brought in Fox 2 News anchor and legal analyst Charlie Langton to help sort out the legal drama.
Luckily, this doesn't happen every day. However, if you've got kind of a common name or you've been out with some people, it could happen. It's probably more common than we think.
With the case pending, friend of the court recently inquired about D'Angelo's employment for possible garnishment down the line.
The state has a duty to figure out his finances, because if he doesn't pass the test or the test shows that he is the father, they want to get this going right now. Remember, the state has no time limit. Well, 18 years anyway.
It made it not something that was being alleged. Now it's something that's being taken into action, and there's no paternity been established.
I think at some point the mother is going to show up, because the mother wants to make sure.
Here's the part that I think is very jarring. No paternity was established. However, you were requesting his job information to set up garnishment procedures, which means that once you enter that paperwork and give them your information, someone miraculously, I said the word wrong, is going to push something through and you're going to start getting deducted for child support before it's all said and done. And then If I remember correctly, they don't refund that money back. Now, I could be wrong. Again, I'm speaking on Michigan, not other states. I don't recall anyone in Michigan ever getting any monies refunded back. But if they did, and they can point me to a link, a video of some sort, you know, from a news source, I would love to see that. But garnishment is sort of like the next step to ruining your life if that child isn't yours. Okay? This was a mess.
To make sure that she's got a father, because she wants the money too. I mean, there are benefits there that she's not getting hold of until she cooperates and does that test. So, Mom, if you're out there, show up.
And listen to what he said. She wants her money too, because that's just what I said at the beginning of the video. In order for you to get cash assistance, in order for you to get food stamps and Medicaid, they want a name of some sort. Remember, I told you, women gonna lie and make one up. They gonna, by pulling one just out of the air, they're gonna pin it on someone, or they're gonna turn in their real child's father in order to get their particular benefits.
In the meantime, this husband and father is determined to clear his name.
If this was even a possibility of being my child, I would not be in front of a news camera trying to put this out here.
We called friend of the court in Benton Harbor several times for a comment. So far, we have not heard back, but we will keep trying.
Okay, this is quite the complicated story. This is crazy. And hearing from Charlie, too, that this can happen, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
As journalists, we have to get both sides.
Of course.
So I'm assuming that you reached out to the alleged mother. If so, what did you hear from her?
All right, so there was a woman laid out in the documents.
Okay.
Lady based in Benton Harbor.
Right.
Not naming
okay.
her, telephone number, address in Benton Harbor. We called the lady on these court documents.
Mm-hmm.
So when we called, someone answered, and we laid out the situation. That lady said, I had nothing to do with this. I don't know what you're talking about. That was the end of the initial conversation. But then she kept on calling me, asking me more questions about this man's situation. And she asked if she could contact him. Of course, we said no.
Right.
But the fact that we called the alleged mother on the court documents, and she responded initially saying no, but then kept on calling me back, asking more questions, it draws even more questions about this whole scenario and how often something like this could potentially happen.
Okay, so what happens now? We have to wait until the alleged mother brings her child to the court?
Apparently, that's how it appears.
Wow.
In the meantime, D'Angelo Smith, he's reaching out to lawmakers to see if some kind of legislation can be created, because we're not questioning the procedure, but more so the process.
I see.
How the mother and the child allegedly have not been tested for genetic testing, but D'Angelo Smith has. Maybe there's a reversal there. Again, these are questions that are being presented. He's also starting up a Facebook page. I think it's called Not So Friend of the Court Community. He's hoping to build more support on social media as well.
Wow.
In this particular matter. So it's a wild one.
Yeah.
That could happen to anyone.
Keep following this for us.
Oh.
It's definitely not done here.
No. Far from that.
We'll see right after the break.
Ain't that crazy? Dealing with having a child that's not yours pinned on you is extremely dangerous. Relationship destroying. And just the person themselves, financially, reputation, the whole nine. So let's get into the update, which posted about 8 hours ago. Your girl been at work, and I'll give my commentary on it. And let's talk.
She don't know me. How did you just put my name down? How did you just put anybody's names down?
I don't know her, never seen her. Still to this day, haven't talked to her. And it just proved out that the baby has no ties to my name. Thankfully, the lady did bring the child in to get tested. And that's all I needed to happen.
This letter from friend of the court reads in part, Dear Mr. Smith, enclosed is a copy of the genetic test results, excluding you as the father.
Let's just set the record. I trust my husband because I know his character. Man of integrity.
I would like to say relief, but it's kind of like confirmation, really, because I already knew that I had no ties and no links to this child or this woman. And to have that letter come to my house, it was a little unnerving, but not from the standpoint of being caught up in something. It was a little unnerving that, a letter like this could come to my house having no legitimacy to it.
We first brought you the story of D'Angelo Smith in late January when he presented some wild allegations against friend of the court in Berrien County. The initial letter sent to his home stated, a woman who we are not naming alleging him to be the father of her daughter, a child between the age of 1 and 2 years old.
She's a stripper from Detroit. We had a one-night stand at some hotel that we supposed to have been and went to, and this is a story that was told to me.
While playing the waiting game for the alleged mother to bring in the baby for a DNA sample, the school where D'Angelo Smith teaches received an inquiry for possible garnishment if things did not go in his favor.
Where it made it not something that was being alleged, now it's something that's being taken into action, and there's no paternity been established.
But clearly, these test results confirm that to no longer be the case.
With that being said, strong marriage or not, clean past or not, that's a very tough letter for anyone to receive.
Absolutely.
Without
Absolutely.
Any proof.
Absolutely. It is. The main thing.
I want to jump in here and say, it's irking my spirit. I know it doesn't matter. It irks my spirit that they're not releasing her name. I understand if they release her name, she will receive backlash that she deserves. You tried to pin a child on a man that was not his, and you deserve some backlash. Now, on one hand, some people will say, well, how do we know that they didn't have sex and he just got lucky? At the end of the day, we don't know. The wife is confident. She trusts her husband. Her husband says he never stepped out on the marriage. Don't know who she is. And so I'm going to take the word of the family. The wife is confident in that. That's what it is. However, these are the situations that can ruin relationships. This is where doubt can come in. This I couldn't even imagine. One, when she first saw the DNA test from the friends of the court, I could only imagine her heart just stopping, like, are you serious? And then to have to be forced to wait, and then while you wait, the threat of garnishment, only to have it not be his son, I mean, whoever the child is, but still, people are going to have their opinions that, well, he probably, all men cheat. I don't believe that. I don't subscribe to all men cheat. I subscribe to Men are human. Women are human. And if you choose to cheat, you do. And men and women will cheat. But I do believe there are some men that won't cheat. They just going to do right by their lady. I believe that there are some women who won't cheat, okay? But at the end of the day, this was extremely messy. Very unfortunate that it happens a lot more than we think. You could probably tell me in the comments right now, as a wife, maybe, that you're dealing with this issue right now. And the father, your husband or boyfriend, is actually paying for child support because you don't have a legal way to stop it. If they start naming people who lie on people, that might curb it a little bit, okay? Because now your name is out there and people going to be like, oh, I don't really want to, I may want to be careful because you have pinned and you have lied and tried to pin babies on people. But let's get back to it.
Things that they have to provide to the state of Michigan is a name and a birth date and where they live. That's easy information
for
someone to gather off of Google, off of Facebook, off of any kind of social media platform.
People who have checkered past, who have done things in the past, who have, you know, stepped out and did things that was unbecoming of a real man, right? And so, but they changed and they cleaned up their act and they've gotten better, which all of us have the opportunity of doing, of getting better. But a letter like this coming to that house, a man that has changed his ways, that has walked in a different direction.
He's speaking truth.
This letter could be absolutely devastating because of what you've done before.
He is speaking the facts. Imagine, and I may have said it earlier, imagine if the husband had a checkered pass, as he called it. I like that, checkered pass. But he's not done it again. She's changed his ways, and boom, here this come. Talk about ruining a relationship if she didn't want to stand strong, okay? Child, this DNA, this friends of the court, this, now let me be clear. let me put this out in the atmosphere. I support child support. Because there are some men who don't take care of their legitimate biological children. And there are some men that don't want to pay a sufficient amount to do that. Now, I know sometimes child support still don't provide a sufficient amount for those with the income to support it. Because there are some men who pay an exuberant amount of child support and they cannot afford it. They don't earn enough to pay that amount, and the judge ordered it anyway, even with check stubs present. They bought check stubs, they bought their lease, they bought their car note and said, I can only pay three a month. That's $150 every 2 weeks or however they got paid. I can't pay seven. My rent is $1,000. They want the man to basically live in a shelter to pay the mom child support to support their child. Again, I know a lot of times child support can be bitter for both parties, but if it's a good father, even if he ain't shit, if they can't afford to pay it, okay, most men will do what? Quit the job. And then you still don't get no child support. I would rather the father who I'm bitter with work, send me the three so I can get something consistently to help with the child versus sending me nothing. And even if I was very bitter towards my child's father and I wouldn't care if he lived in a shoebox, at the end of the day, that is the child's father. And I want my child to make his own or her own decision on whether they're going to be bothered with the child. But of course, you know, child support go two ways. Child, this is just a messy, it's so many levels to this, okay? Oh, because you got the good father who want to do more for the kid, but the baby mama bitter and won't let him. You got the bitter baby dead child. We can go on. Let's get back to this.
Before
we made several calls to lawmakers in Lansing who are familiar with this particular topic to get some answers.
It's very unfortunate, but paternity fraud is not a unique, unusual
paternity
situation
fraud.
Senator Jim Runstad tells me he's been pushing for new legislation on the matter during the past 8 years, saying right now there's no penalty for lying.
Senator, what was the opposition for not passing this kind of legislation?
Well, maybe it would hinder mothers who don't want to name a particular guy, or they made a mistake, but you had to knowingly name the wrong person. It becomes emotional stuff.
That part, when you knowingly name the wrong person and they can prove that you falsely lied and pinned something on someone, I stand with putting charges, probation, especially if that person ended up paying child support, garnished their wages. They need to pay that all back. The fees to the state and the child's father. Listen, this is a rule that needs to be passed on all the states, child. This is a mess. Because RIP to Jerry Springer. Oh, no, my bad. Jerry Springer didn't do DNA tests. Murray Pulver's still alive. Never mind.
Respectfully, to mandate that DNA testing for the child is conducted first before a letter is sent to someone's home alleging they may be the father of a child regarding a woman whom they have never met, doesn't that seem like common sense type of legislation?
I tell you, Joshua, the common sense goes out the window. I'd be more than happy.
Let me just jump in one more time. I know, Kiva, be quiet. How about doing DNA tests in the hospital when the baby born? They don't do that. Now, if they did it back in the 1800s, and I'm 49, and when I was born, they didn't do it then, okay? There's not been a time in my 49 years a hospital has drew blood and performed a DNA test automatically on the strength. Those had to be court ordered and were already waiting in place. Mind you, I'm stating my 49 years, and I've worked in the medical field, okay, and worked in hospitals. My job is working in hospitals and on the birthing floor. DNA tests need to be, in my opinion, if you want to know that the birthing day, if the hospital say, well, we're not covering it, or if your insurance don't cover it, maybe Medicaid, somebody need to cover it, or you need to set aside your money. I know I get birth in 9 months. To get this DNA test done in the hospital is $500. Y'all need to start saving y'all money. I don't care how much it costs. If you want to know, you need to know right at birth. So that gives everyone time to find out. Here's the twist to that. And it's unfortunate. When you find out somebody lied to you, a lot of times you're going to have domestic violence. And I don't think this is an excuse to put your hands on anybody. However, some men become so enraged that they will get the fucking a bitch up on site, on the spot, okay, that you went 9 months lying to them. So it's a double-edged sword, and that's not me being funny. That's just the reality. You go 9 months, lie to somebody, this your baby, taking pictures, getting family all excited to come, you know, see this baby, and then it ain't there. So, ooh, child, the double-edged sword of lies, of lying, it's damaging. And the ramifications just trickle, trickle, trickle.
Been happy to put that bill in. I'm telling you, it wouldn't even get a hearing in committee. I guarantee you, it wouldn't even get a hearing in committee. I ran across this before.
And the only reason I believe that this woman came in was because of Fox 2. Fox 2 provided a platform where the word got out, and this word spread it like wildfire quickly, to the point where the lady came in. Now, I asked the courts, the friend of the courts, about bringing her in. They said, well, we just have to wait until she comes in. But I thank God that Fox 2 provided a platform.
They need a court order.
The lady was able to come in, but everybody does not have that opportunity for Fox 2 to show up at their doorstep to help them out.
A lot to wrap your head around, guys. Real quick, as we did in our initial story, we called friend of the court for a comment, but have not heard back. In the meantime, Senator Jim Rusted tells me if you're caught in a similar situation, your best option is to hire an attorney if possible. Also, and this is very key, reach out to your lawmakers. The senator says more bipartisanship is much.
And what's unfortunate, low-income families, and I'm not talking about the unemployed. I'm talking about the working families that's making two family incomes, but they're still low income, okay? 30,000 here, 30,000 there. That's 60,000 combined, or 60,000 and they got multiple children. 60K is a decent amount of money for two people household with maybe one kid. You know, I mean, I'm just throwing numbers out there. Lawyers are not cheap. So if you got to hire a lawyer, it's the retainer fee. And you can go through all of that and still don't get no answers. Reaching out to your lawmakers, that's a good thing. But who really going to sit down with pen, pad, and paper and write them an email? I mean, write them a letter. Write an email. Set up a date where you marching around at the buildings and the courthouses demanding justice. I mean, is anybody really? I'm going to tell you now, I'm not getting out marching nothing. I will send a couple of emails. Now, I do that, but I ain't here for the marching. Especially not downtown Detroit, child. You're not going to have me build a Capitol building. But people have to go that extra step. If you're in this position, going that extra step to fight for your rights is easier said than done. But you have to do it. But I don't know how to tell you to do it. I don't. There aren't any loans available. There aren't any grants. That's, you know, maybe you can find a college student lawyer. The lawyers that are doing pro bono, you know, go call a lawyer school where they've passed the bar, but they knew, and maybe see if they'll take a case. So, child,
Much needed on this very touchy matter.
It could destroy a whole relationship. I mean, luckily, here's a guy that has, you know,
he has a solid household.
That's very under. Right. Some people would have packed up and left and said, "I just don't believe you." You could have destroyed a life.
Bingo.
Unbelievable story for them to send that to work. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine if you worked at a certain place and the rumors would start to spread?
Yes.
I mean, it is potentially not only family.
Definition of character in the public eye.
But your character and your life.
Absolutely.
I can't imagine how frustrated that family was while they were trying to get answers.
Highly frustrated, Amy and Jay. Highly frustrated because, again, you're getting an inquiry about your finances without even confirmation if you're connected to this particular case.
Hey, where's the proof? Wow.
A lot more dialogue is needed on this matter, Lansing, for sure.
Thanks for bringing that to light.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
And speaking of defamation, people were slandering the husband. They were slandering the wife, saying she's a liar. You just weak. That nigga cheated. He a cheater. Like, when I tell y'all, it was a hot mess in some of the forums, statuses that I saw. So, at the end of the day, I'm very happy that the DNA cleared him. He's not going to have his check garnished. I'm glad that their marriage has maintained through this. Let me know. Drop down in the comments if you're going through this. I actually want to interview somebody. Well, that is it. That is all. I thought this was an excellent story to bring to the floor to have some conversation, because not everyone goes through this process of false allegations and come out on the winning end. He was able to clear his name and not get his check garnished, and so many men end up stuck, their families end up affected and stuck. Having your pay garnished and money taken out of your household for a child that is not yours is devastating, because now you're budgeting for someone that's not your kid, and it breeds animosity. You know, it breeds arguments, because it's a constant reminder every time you get paid, I'm going to be short for a child that's not mine, that I'm stuck with and I don't have any way to fight it. He said, thankfully, Fox 2 News put it out there. If it wasn't for Fox 2 News, he feel he would still be caught up and probably would be being garnished right to this day, unable to prove what happened. So be sure to comment below your thoughts. And again, thank you for being here. And I'll see you guys in the next video.
This commentary. Bye.